Hi Nine viewers, I'm Dr. Prabhat Reddy Lakkireddy. I'm a senior orthopedic surgeon at Apollo Hospitals in Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad. Today we are here to discuss about common orthopedic problems. So today we're going to discuss about how do you treat damaged cartilage. First of all, we should understand that cartilage, which is the protective lining of the knee joint, which is here, as you saw, does only form once in our lifetime, which means after the age of 16, it does not form. If at all there is some damage, there is some amount of healing which occurs up to the age of 35. After the age of 35, there is absolutely no healing with the cartilage damage. So important thing is here is, for the cartilage, prevention is better than cure. So try to save your cartilage, try to prevent any injuries. But obviously you can't prevent any sports injuries which are lead to cartilage damage. So the common treatments for a cartilage damage are, for initial patients who come in the initial stages, we treat them with medical treatment like glucosamine, and we have newer modalities like univastin and a lot of new medication which have come up to help in some amount of cartilage formation. But obviously what we take through the mouth does not reach much into the area which is damaged. So majority of it does not actually work. When the patients come at a later stages, then we go always, most of the treatments are surgical treatments. And the common minimal invasive surgical treatments what we have, or we talk about nowadays, we talk about stem cell treatments. We should not call them stem cells, but we can call them as orthobiologics. Orthobiologic treatments are what is available. The best one what we do today is called regrow, where we grow the, take a sample of the cartilage from the knee joint and grow it in the laboratory. And after the growth, the growth takes about 4 weeks. After 4 weeks, we re-implant into the knee joint. It's called regrow. Regrow has the best results. And the next one down the line, not the best, down the line, we have is a BMAC, bone marrow aspirate concentrate, where we take some amount of blood from our pelvic bone, where we have live stem cells. We filter them through a special process and we identify separate mesenchymal stem cells, which are stem cells which can be grown into a cartilage. These stem cells are mixed and applied into the area of the cartilage damage. That's called BMAC procedure. And the third procedure, which is very minimal invasive, is called PRP, which is called platelet-rich plasma, where we take some amount of venous blood, normal blood from our body, take some venous blood and you filter it to different process and you get about few ml of PRPs, which are high concentration of platelets, about 6 to 7 times concentrated. So platelets, as you know, when they're given into any particular part of the body, they actually starts releasing growth factors. Like suppose you have a cut in your skin, even if you don't touch, don't do anything, it heals up. The reason why the healing occurs is because of the platelets. It's the same principle what we use for PRP. So when you inject the same PRPs into the damaged cartilage area, it starts regenerating. It's some amount of regeneration, not the best results like regrow, but helps in some regeneration. If all these minimally invasive surgical treatments are exhausted or not suitable, especially in patients who come with a severe arthritis, then we do a total knee replacement. Total knee replacement, as we obviously say, so this is the total joint which is damaged. So when this is the stage where we come and none of the treatments work, then we end up doing a total knee replacement, where we remove the damaged cartilage area and instead of that we put a prosthetic joint. Obviously a surgery well done can last more than 25 years or so, and this is a very good procedure. Okay, thank you very much.